All right, let me show you how you can edit your brand new Canva template. So I'm going to be going over just the basics of how you can edit your Canva templates, and I'm going to be sharing some of my favorite tips that really speed up your workflow, so you might not actually know about them even if you're familiar with this platform. So when you open up your Canva templates, this is what it's going to look like. And if you don't already have a free Canva account set up, Canva is going to prompt you to do that. I do want you to know that all of these templates are designed so that they can be used with a free account. You do not have to have the pro version. Canva is such a popular design platform right now because it's so intuitive, it's so easy to use. So don't be afraid. If you haven't used this platform before, it's very intuitive. And I'm going to just show you the basics here of how you can edit these templates. And that's really all you're going to need in order to use these templates, is just the very basics. So first of all, you should know that every single thing in these templates is customizable. So you can change out the colors, the photos, the fonts, the text. You can delete things, you can add things, anything that you want. So let's start with the photos. So these photos that I've added are just placeholders. You get these photos with your template purchase. So whichever bundle you have your own set of photos. So you can mix and match, switch them out here. You can keep these photos that I've already placed in here for you. But let me just go ahead and delete this photo so you see what it looks like without the photo in there. So with Canva, photo placeholders look like this, kind of like this cartoon landscape. So whenever you see that, it just means that you can drag and drop a photo there. So I'm going to go over to the left-hand side. Over here, you're going to go to uploads. So this is where all the photos that you upload are going to be nicely organized. So you're going to see images and also videos. So if you upload any videos, they're going to be located right here. So let's go ahead and show you how you upload. So you just click this purple button that says upload media, go to device, and now you're going to choose wherever it is on your computer that you keep your photos. So in downloads, I have all of these images, so I can just go ahead and click on one of these. And it's going to upload it right here. I'm just going to go ahead and grab one of these photos I already have in here and drag it and drop it into this photo placeholder. So you can see that it perfectly forms it to this spot. Once I have it there, I can double click on it and then I can move the photo around to place it however I want it. So let's just go ahead and show another example here. I can just drag and drop it there. It already looks good, but you can see how I can move this around so that it fits perfectly in that spot. Next, I want to show you how you can switch out a color throughout your entire design in one click. So I'm going to be focusing on this background color. So first of all, when you want to switch out a color, you just click on whichever element it is that you want to change the color, whether it's fonts or background, or any of these little design elements, you just click on it and then you can switch it out. So let's focus on this background. So this background is this kind of light pink. I'm going to go up here and click on this little color box here and it pulls up the color panel. So I can choose any of these colors that are already here for me, or I can add my own color by going up here to this plus button and adding a hex code. I can also change the color by dragging and dropping this. It's really, really simple. So I'm going to go back to the original blush and now I'm going to choose a new color. I'm going to go ahead and choose kind of this green color. So once I change that color, it's going to pop up and say change all on the bottom and it shows my blush pink and then it shows this kind of olive green color. So I'm going to go ahead and click change all. And it has instantly changed that color throughout my entire design. But I do want to show you a couple of things that you might encounter when you are editing these graphics. So I've gone through and I've tried to make it as simple as possible. I've tried to set it up so that you can change out colors in one click. However, you might experience a situation like this. So you'll see that this background color is still that blush pink color. It didn't get changed out. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this and show you why that is. So when I click on this element, which is still the pink color, it didn't get switched out to the olive green, you're going to see that there is a lock box here showing in the corner. It says this element can't be edited. So you're going to see up here, there's that lock box. So that just means that this element is locked. And the reason why some elements are locked is because once a background is in place that I don't want to change or move, I can lock that so that you can't change the color, you can't move it around. However, you can select things on the top of that element and move those around, no problem. So everything else around that element can be moved, but that one stays in place. No problem at all. All you do is you select that element and then you go ahead up here and you click unlock, and now that element can be changed. So I'm going to go ahead again and change it to this green color. So that's one issue you might encounter, which is no problem at all. You can just easily finesse that. And I'm just going to go ahead and get things back to normal. So the second issue that you might experience is a grouping. So when I click on this, if I want to change out this text, you're going to see that there is a blue little line box around this, but there's also this dotted blue box around this. That means that these elements here, which would usually be separate, so this font, and this background would usually be separate elements. But in this case, they're grouped together. And what's cool about that is that you can just click on this and then it all moves together. So you don't have to worry about messing it up, like accidentally selecting one of the text boxes and moving it, and all of a sudden, oops, now you've messed up the margin space. No problem, you just move it all together. However, there could be a situation in which you want to change one of these elements. For instance, you might want to stretch out this background color, but you can't do that if these are grouped together. So I want you to just be aware of this so that it's really easy for you to change it. All you do is click on this grouping, it highlights this group, and then you go up here and you click ungroup. So now you're going to see that change. There's a solid line around each of these elements. So now they can be selected separately and changed. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on this background color, and now I can stretch that out however I want to. So let's talk about the fonts. You are going to want to switch out the fonts probably. So I want to show you, Canva hasn't come up with the opportunity to select a particular font and change that font throughout your entire design like they have with the color yet, but they have created something pretty cool. So the capability that makes it really easy to change out your fonts is that you can select multiple font boxes and change them at the same time. So for instance, we're going to look at this. These body fonts in this is Glacial Indifference, and this font is a header font and it's Beleza. So that's a separate font, and I kind of want to stay with as close to this design as possible. So I want to make sure that I keep this as a header font, but I want to change out the body font here. And all you do is you highlight those two text boxes. You're going to see it says Glacial Indifference up here. You're going to drop this down, and that's going to open up the fonts. You can change any and use any of these fonts that you want. The one thing I do want to let you know is that if there's a little crown next to a font, it means that you have to have a pro account in order to use this font. So I do have a pro account. I can use that font, but you might not. So you can also type in whichever font you want to change this to. So you have a fonts guide that you can choose a different font pairing and easily switch these out if you want to. I'm going to switch this to Source Sans Pro, and it changes both of these text boxes at the same time. If you want all of these fonts to be changed to the same font, you can do that. They don't have to be the same fonts. You could select as many fonts as you want, and we can change that to whichever font we choose. So that makes it quick and easy to change out your fonts. One more font trick that I want to share with you, just in case it comes in handy at any point, is you can go ahead and click on a font where maybe you have changed something about it. So maybe I'm going to change this to Yaseva 1, and I'm going to change this sizing to 50. And maybe I'll change the color to this bright orange. So once I have that how I want it, if I want to change another heading in another one of these designs to this exact same standards, I can just go ahead and highlight this text. Then I'm going to go up to this paintbrush, and it's going to copy every single thing that I just changed this to. So the color, the sizing, and the font. Then I can go down here and I can just click on that, and it adds exactly the same details there. Notice that it straightened it out, it's not curved anymore, it's got the color, it's got the font, it's got everything. So I can also go ahead and do that again, just grab the paintbrush tool and I can click here. It's going to change it to the same thing. So just in case that comes in handy at any point, that's a really fun trick. And finally, you're just going to need to know how you can download your design. So you're just going to go ahead and go up here to the download button. You can choose any of these forms that you want. If you're posting this to Instagram, choose the JPEG. Make sure that your quality is at 100, and then you can select whichever pages you want to download. So right now it's selected all. So I can click this again, it unselects all of them. And then I can choose whichever pages that I want, and then click done and download.